Good morning all, Donna here with another Disney vlog. Woke up at 4:45 this morning, got in the shower, had to wash my hair, you can see it's all wiry at the moment. Today we are eating at Ohana and we are popping to Florida Mall to do some shopping. I've got to try and find a hair towel because I don't want to change the colour of these ones in the hotel. And then we are going to EPCOT later on as well. So that will be fun. I can't wait. Whilst we were in Animal Kingdom yesterday, I spotted a really nice blue jacket and it has like gold piping on it and patchwork sleeves, and on the back it has like the 50th anniversary decorations for Disney World. So naturally I like the look of that. It was $90, but I tried it on, which was really difficult to do when you're in 30 degree heat because it's so warm, but I couldn't fit into an XXL because it was too big. So I couldn't fit into a 3XL definitely because it just drowned me. So we tried an XL and it fits me all right, because I even tried a large and it was too tight. I knew straight away since I put my arm in the sleeve I wouldn't get it on. So we tried an XL and it fit beautifully. So I now have myself a lovely blue jacket for when I go home. And obviously in the UK it's cold at this time of the year now, whereas here it's heat wave. Heat that we are not accustomed to, so lots of hydration is required. I've had to change the way I do my vlogs for the holiday because we're here for 2 weeks. It makes it difficult trying to do day one, day two, day, I'll be at it forever. So what I'm doing is a vlog for each part that I visit over the 2 weeks and combine them together, so we'll have lots of b-roll to add in as well. I'm going to show us on the rides. My favorite one yesterday was Expedition Everest. I absolutely love it, but after a couple times on it I started feeling a bit dizzy, a little bit sick feeling with the dizziness because I'm not accustomed to turns, really big turns on roller coasters. Then especially when you're going backwards or in the dark, it was like whoa, my head. And my second favorite was Flight of Passage. That was incredible. I really enjoyed that ride. How they've managed to do the technology to be able to do that ride, I was amazed by it. But it got bumped to number 2 as I thoroughly enjoyed Expedition Everest. So today we'll see what EPCOT brings and see if I have a new favourite ride in this park as well. So let's get this video on the go. Thank you. We've been to EPCOT and went on loads of rides. Mission Space, Spaceship Earth, Test Track, Soaring, and probably a couple that I can't remember. And amazing, absolutely amazing. I bought some things, new Crocs and that today when we went to Florida Mall. Got to watch a bit of a firework display as well, so that was nice. Apparently there's going to be a lunar eclipse tonight, so I'm going to be getting up tomorrow morning to try and catch the moon before it disappears behind the buildings and see if I can spot this lunar eclipse, because it's going to be a proper full one. Everything seems to be happening while we're in America, and it's great, you know. We don't know about Artemis because apparently there's a forecast of a tropical storm. So there's a possibility that Artemis is going to get scrubbed again. Also visited a craft shop called Michael's, which is quite well known in America. And I bought some sticker books for my journaling when I get home. And I bought a Starbucks cup as well, which I don't normally get anything from Starbucks regarding stuff like this, but I saw it and I really liked it because of the colours. So now I have this official Starbucks mug. I hope that wasn't a waste of $25 when it comes to it, but actually, yeah, I think it's it can look quite nudie on my journaling desk. Also got myself this nice big t-shirt from Walmart, and it's so big on me. Even when I tried to find a smaller size, it was too small. So this oversized Mickey Mouse is now my t-shirt, which I'm actually tempted to wear tomorrow. Who knows? We shall see. We will be spending another day at EPCOT, so there will be lots more footage to come to add to this vlog. Good morning, everyone. This is like day something or other, and I am continuing my EPCOT vlog today because we are spending the day at EPCOT. Hold the phone, where's the staircase? There it is. So hopefully after today I will be finished with the EPCOT vlog, editing it and then posting it on YouTube for you to enjoy. Now I know my videos aren't the best because I'm not an experienced vlogger, I'm not an annual pass holder, so all the vlogs you see from people who are there here all the time have much more immersive vlogs to go from and advice for Disney World, which has helped us a lot before we came. So I'm just trying to do the best I can as a small vlogger. And not necessarily making it informative, but to take you along on our holiday as we venture around all the parks. God, man, I'm out of breath. I hate stairs. They just tire me out. I'm so fat. So, yeah, let's continue our day at EPCOT. Couldn't get my port of entry medallions, the machine doesn't work, so I might have to come back again in the week and pick it up and see if the machine's working again. Mm. far, we've had a really nice time at the food and wine festival at the EPCOT showcase. And we've tried a couple of things here. We had a pretzel from Germany, and we had a cherry cello from Italy, and we're getting some shaved ice from Japan. Not sure what we're going to have yet, but we are just keeping moving. And it's been a good day so far here. It's been really, really enjoyable. While we've been out looking at the showcase today, we have been on the hunt for the elusive Mr. Morrow, and we've not spotted him yet because we would love to say hello to him. We think he might be in Epcot today, we don't actually know, but we've watched a lot of his videos prior to coming to Disney World about food and different places in the park, so it would be amazing if we could say hello to him, even in a quick photo. We don't know. But unfortunately, we've been here all day and we've not found him yet. We're making our way back through Epcot now. We still haven't found Mr. Morrow. The search does continue. I really hope one day I get to drive a Camaro like this. It is gorgeous.
How was
We're about to go on Cosmic Rewind, which we've waited 7 hours for in a virtual queue. Possibly more, but here we go and see what it is like.
Ascending data. They are also serving as ambassadors, carrying greetings from you Terrans to the universe.
They form a starship, resembling the Novacord logo.
The wonders of Xandar. As you have seen, your world and ours were born of the same moment, one which you refer to as the Big Bang. As such, We are all galactic neighbors in a vast universe which we and countless others share. For you to travel to Xandar would take 2.5 million years, assuming you had a ship that could fly at the speed of light. So we decided to come to you. But even we could not have reached you so easily were it not for the Cosmic Generator, an advanced piece of Xandarian technology that creates jump points, artificial tunnels that act as shortcuts, linking distant points in space. It is our desire to share this wondrous technology with your people so that together we might explore new worlds and create a brighter tomorrow. And now, as the culmination of the wonders of Xandar, you will be teleported to a Nova ship above your planet for a demonstration of the Cosmic Generator. I trust you will find it an unforgettable experience.
We have just got off Cosmic Rewind, and it was worth it. It was an incredible roller coaster. Nothing I've ever been on before, and it absolutely blew my mind. Now, I didn't get footage of it because it's a very dark kind of ride, so you wouldn't be able to film it on a GoPro, and you're not allowed. However, you really have to give it a try if you do come to Walt Disney World, because it's just phenomenal, absolutely amazing. Best ride I've been in yet, and it's probably my favourite ride in EPCOT now. So, yeah, unbelievable, absolutely unbelievable.
Voices calling out in search of one another, we find each other in song.
She wants to be far. It's truly the spark. Choices. take a loop in the operation office to encourage the noise.
We're actually going to see if we can go into the Space 220 restaurant, which is supposed to be very, very popular. So, well, we don't know if we can get in. We're going to find out now. We are going into the bar at Space 220 restaurant, and it's supposed to be quite the experience, and we're going to go and experience it right now. Oh my god, can't wait. This is our ticket to the bar. Very swag.
No. Having diagnosis. Go. Magnetic field. Go. Grab the generator. Go. At load station, this is Centauri Control. The checklist is complete. You are confirmed. Go for departure. Stand by for liftoff. Roger.
In just a few moments, you'll be on your way up to Space 220 aboard the Centauri Space Station. Enjoy the ride.
SV2, you are clear to departure. Initiate in 3, 2, 1, liftoff.
You're riding aboard the Mark 5 Stellavator, the latest in space elevator design and technology. You'll have a spectacular view of Florida and the Eastern Seaboard. Enjoy the ride. I'll be back in a bit with arrival information.
Calamari is amazing. Done test track during the day with the GoPro, so We're going to head over there in a minute, and I'm going to get a video of it in the daylight, as it'll be better than at night. And I like Test Track. I really enjoy Test Track. But I think that probably be my second favourite, with Cosmic Rewind as being my first. When you can actually get on it, obviously. So I made the mistake of putting my GoPro on the bench, and it slid off and cracked the lens. We've just had a look online. You can buy replacements, and you can also remove the lens. We've just tried to remove it now, and it does detach. So yeah, I didn't really think that one through, but it is thankfully repairable. So we'll just have to go on Amazon when we get home and order a new lens, so that we can take this one off and replace it with a brand new one. Oops.
Vehicle designs perform under challenging weather and surface conditions.
Monitoring road surface.
Ready to go back on Cosmic Rewind. I've actually been looking forward to this one. We only done it once, and we're waiting until what time at night to go on it?
Half past eight.
But now it's like coming up 6 o'clock, so we've got on it earlier this time, and we're going to go and enjoy it because it's the most amazing ride ever. And I can't video on there, so I'm going to drop a link in the description of someone's YouTube video of the ride for people to enjoy. But until then, I'm going on it.
Cast moving shadows across the city. Something Xandar is famous for.
Was just as good as it was the first time I went on it. I can't wait to come back to EPCOT in a year or so's time to go on it again, because it is worth the wait.
That's right. That's right.
Goodbye, EPCOT. That's our day at EPCOT all done now, and we're heading back to the car. Finish off packing as we fly tomorrow evening back to the UK. We're getting a quick bite of something to eat, and then we are going back to our room to start packing, ready for home. When we went on Cosmic Rewrite for the pre-show, we experienced like a blackout on a part where it's supposed to transport you to a ship, and I went black a lot longer than it should have. And in that darkness, someone decided to shout. It was actually quite funny, but by then the doors had opened and everyone had moved on. But yeah, it was brilliant. So that is the end of our video and end of our holiday. We're going to be packing now, ready for leaving to go home tomorrow, back to the UK. Back to jumping 5 hours ahead, so I imagine there'll be some jet lag. If you've enjoyed this video, please hit subscribe, tap on the bell. You'll get a notification of video goes online. I really hope you've enjoyed my Disney vlogs. And the next vlog I do will be when I'm back in the UK and pretty much settled back into normal life again. But until that time, I'll see you guys soon and stay safe.